don't know what to say. Like, I really want to say white fragility, but then I know somebody gonna be in the comment section, why you always gotta bring race into it? Because everything is about race. It's Harianna and I'm back with another video. Hi, hello, how are you guys doing? My name is Harianna and welcome to or welcome back to the Fire Ship, also known as Harry Hicks Fire Ship. I am the captain, you are not my first mate. I don't got no first mate because nobody's worthy of being the first mate. Hi, hello, you're new and it's your first time ever seeing me. My name is Harianna and I like to make content based off nostalgia and family and children's entertainment and all the issues that I find within those spaces. Now, my space is different today simply because we are doing a story time today. We are not doing a video analysis or anything. This is just something funny that happened last night specifically, and something that it's just been a minute. It's just been a lot of things that have built up to this point, and I want to just get on here and talk to you about them because I kind of think it's a little comical. By the way, this video is not me over here wearing it as like a badge of honor, because as the title says, it is not clickbait. I have been blocked by the creator of Miraculous Ladybug. I'm actually surprised that it just now happened. He didn't block me sooner, because the man has made it obvious that he is aware of like my content and me and many other people's on YouTube, because he's like Dan Schneider. He's a lurker, okay? Dan Schneider made it pretty clear that he saw my videos. He was just not it. But I just want to sit down here and talk to you guys about the story of how this came about. And yeah, so the first thing we need to do for me to get it ready is that I need to go ahead and wash my face. So I'm gonna go wash my face and then I will be back. Y'all, it is actually very hot in here, okay? And me talking is not making that shit any better. Wait, I always think of like random songs while I'm in the middle of getting dressed. And the random song I was thinking of I Love Your Girl by The Dream, but it's that one specific part in the chorus where he's just like, she called over there and she like, fuck that nigga, I'm like, shawty, you should go. He called me over there. She like, fuck that nigga. Well, how did that part go again? I used to know that shit by heart. Hold on. No, I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna figure it out in a minute. After I put this shit on my face, I'm gonna get my phone and look up that part. But yeah, this is Cetaphil moisturizer if anyone was interested in the moisturizer I'm using. But hold on, no, I'm gonna look up that song. What's so weird is that I usually know this song by heart. My friend has a whole video of me singing this shit in the vehicle. Hold up. I Love Your Girl by The Dream lyrics. Okay. She run her fingers through her hair. She kind of call him over there and she like, fuck that nigga. She dropping to the floor. I'm like, shorty, you should go. And she like, fuck that nigga. Okay. I got it out. So now we can go back to our regular scheduled programming. Oh, how did Creative Miraculous Ladybug block me? How does this come about? Okay. So before I go, I just want to let you guys know that this man is grown and has a whole kid. He is pushing 50 and he be over here going off back and forth with 20 somethings and teenagers on Twitter. So do what you want with that information. I'm taking this serum. It is Olay 24-hour serum. I am going to put this on my face. And you guys keep seeing me turn around. It's simply because I just need the mirror to do what I gotta do. Oh my gosh. This, okay, I have to do it like this. I need to get a new one. Okay, and I don't want to put too much of this on my face. So, like I mentioned, this man has a history of, you know, going back and forth with people on Twitter and shit like that. And yes, some of the comment people that he has blocked, it was for very valid reasons. But a lot of the times he has blocked people for giving his show constructive criticism. If you say something that he does not like about Miss Miraculous Ladybug, he will block you, okay? Okay, like his masculinity is so fragile. Like I told you, this entire situation is just white fragility, okay? Because a lot of these reasons why so many people get blocked by Thomas Ash Cheeks. That's just a little nickname I have. By the way, y'all, people be saying I shouldn't do that. I'm just letting y'all know, this man has shown that he is racist. He has made it clear that he has a lot of microaggressions towards black people and whatnot. Just look at his work. And then when we tried to call him out about that shit on Twitter, he was like, y'all overreacted. It ain't that deep. I don't care. It's not that serious. I have no respect for racist people, okay? I don't. And people are like, well, you watch this show, you should respect him. No, I don't, okay? So if you're watching this, Thomas, hey boo, okay? So I wanted to get on here and talk to you guys about why this came about, okay? So there have been, he has just been known to like go on like Twitter blocking sprees and whatever. Okay, I understand there are people out here that deserve a good block, but this man is weird, okay? He goes out of his way to search very little and specific stuff to find people talking shit about either him or Miraculous Ladybug, and then he blocks them. And that's one thing I always could not stand, when famous people would literally, like, nobody would at them or anything. Nobody would be adding these people. Nobody, like, I think the only time you all warranted a block if you at, if someone asked you, okay? They literally would type in their name on Twitter or whatever, literally look up to see what people are saying about them negatively, and then, like, oh, and then block them. Like, we never added you, dude. Oh my god, why is this burning? But y'all, I don't even wear that. I have to go to work today. That's the main reason why I'm putting on makeup. And the thing about it is that I'm already dressed and ready to go, because they give me my costume when I get there. Y'all, I did not know I had to be on set tomorrow until like 12 o'clock at night. But I'm sorry, it's taking me a minute to get it. I don't want to be turned away from you guys for too long. There has been a lot of drama going on lately when it comes to, is my brush still wetting up? Okay. There's been a lot of drama lately when it has come to Miraculous Ladybug and the battle of like the streaming and the episodes being released, because we are at the end of season 4 as when this video is being made. It's probably not going to come out until season 4 is done, simply because it's February. I'm still on my break on YouTube while I'm filming this. It's been a lot of drama going on lately. Not really like the fans or anything like that, because simply we had the episode early and we watched it legally. We didn't really do anything wrong. There's been like a lot of drama going on lately because all the remaining episodes except for the season finale have been released to the public. And the funny thing about it is that it's not like it's like a French release like Glooberies said. No, this shit is Disney Channel. It has Disney Channel's name all over it, okay? And it first started with Spectrum, but I have Xfinity and I have YouTube TV also. That shit was there too. So this entire situation is just like very funny, because at first they did it with Risk, which is part 1 of the season finale. They didn't do it with Strike Back, which is part 2 of the season finale. The funny thing about this is because after they released that episode, they released like 3 more earlier than they were supposed to be. So next thing you know, we find out that Thomas is beyond pissed off. He's like, stop watching these episodes, yada yada, this and that and the third. Like, he is pissy. He is having a bitch fit, y'all. The biggest one I've seen from him. Now, I've seen this man's tantrums and whatnot on Twitter. And a lot of these tantrums will come from people telling him, like, giving him, like, valid constructive criticism. Like, there are some people that are just out here being rude, but there are people that have given him valid constructive criticism or called him out for being racist. And he would be like, shut up, you're just being rude. I'm like, no, now I gotta get rude because you are being disrespectful to my culture. Hey, so we got that done. What is next? Mascara. It doesn't really take a lot for me to get rid of y'all, okay? That's why I'm like, I'm literally halfway done and I am mostly finished. Like, it doesn't really take much for me to get ready to go to work. I had to take my jewelry off though, because they always give me jewelry to put on. I feel like that would like make me look more awake. Everybody's just like, why is Disney Channel doing this, yada yada yada, because it's obvious that this was a Disney Channel thing. It wasn't a cable company thing. This was all on Disney Channel. Now I'm gonna take you guys back in time to December of 2021. Remember that time period when everybody was sick at their house catching COVID? That time period, okay? During this time period, there was a small little movie that had come out. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of it. If you have, you haven't. If you don't, you know. The girls who know, know. And this film is called Encanto, okay? I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have seen Encanto who's watching this video. But Encanto basically is this Disney movie about this Colombian family, cute little movie about people of color. Very, very nice film, okay? Very beautifully done. We don't talk about Bruno, but it was my wedding day. Encanto is Disney's newest release that has been out yet. I don't know if Disney's released anything else, but I really loved Encanto. I really enjoyed it. I cried like a fucking motherfucker after I watched that shit because it just hurt me so damn bad, okay? I was extremely hurt. This movie read everyone's filth, all right? So, Thomas, on the other hand, did not like the film. He did not like Encanto whatsoever, and I completely understand that, okay? Not everybody is gonna like what you like, yada yada yada, but one thing a lot of white people don't seem to get is when they talk about how much they don't like movies that center around people of color, a lot of times this happens with black people specifically. They always start going off about how bad they don't like the movie, and some of what he was saying was a little bit racially insensitive, and we were telling him, hey, you most likely shouldn't say that, that's rude. And he was like, this is just my opinion. One thing I can't stand is when you call white people out for being racist, they be like, that's just my opinion. Racism is not an opinion, baby. It is not. So not only was he going off about Encanto, he started going off talking about how Miraculous Ladybug, it's better. And have any of y'all seen Miraculous Ladybug?
Chloe went through those shoes. The sneakers must be here somewhere. Five more minutes, I'm almost. Chloe's sister's sneakers. Where are they? Huh? What? I don't know.
This show, I don't think Thomas Ashton seems to understand that part of the reason why Miraculous Ladybug is as popular as it is because people watch it to make fun of it, or they watch it to, like, you know, redo it. There's a lot of people out here redoing Miraculous Ladybug. Oh my god. Okay, we're gonna wait. We gonna wait to do that in a minute, okay? That so many people were making fun of this show for being terrible. He started talking about how his show was better, and he was talking about how his animation on his show was better. Have y'all seen Miraculous Ladybug's animation? If he was talking season one, yeah. No. He was really bragging and going off about how he think his work is so much better than Disney's and Encanto. We were like, bitch, bye. Hush. Sure, Thomas. Okay, sure, Dan. So next thing we know, he was just talking all this shit about Encanto. People were telling him, hey, you're being rude, you're being racially insensitive. And he started going on his blogging spree again, as he usually does when we call him out for just being an asshole. Like, he can be the biggest dickhead ever, y'all. And it makes no sense whatsoever. So I'm trying to put all the pieces together. Miraculous Ladybug airs on Disney Channel. No, it is not a Disney show. It is a Zagtoon show. It's not like a Disney original or anything like that. But Disney owns part of the rights to Miraculous Ladybug. Miraculous Ladybug in America is distributed by two programs. It is distributed by Netflix, and it's also distributed by Disney Channel. When it is actually airing on television, when it is on cable, it is airing on Disney Channel, okay? They play Miraculous Ladybug like damn near 9 times a day, okay, on Disney Channel. They play that show quite often, okay? They play that show, like, Nickelodeon really fumbled the bag when it came to the series. They play this shit like twice a week. And opposed to twice a week to like 9 times a day, Disney Channel is gonna make sure they do what they can with the rights of this series, okay? So, remember what I told you about how Thomas was talking all that mad shit about Encanto? Putting two and two together, and I was like, I'm starting to think this is Disney's way of telling him to shut the fuck up. Like, I was just like putting two and two together because it didn't really make sense why Disney was doing this. And usually when a lot of shit like this happens behind the scenes, it means something behind the scenes went down, okay? I work in the film industry. I understand. I'm not nothing big in the industry, by the way. I just, the highest position I've ever had was photo double standing. And then I do a lot of independent production. So I understand how film and all that shit works. That meant some shady shit had to be going on behind the scenes for them to put all them episodes out lately. And then I put two and two together and I was like, what if this is Disney's way of getting back at him for talking shit about Encanto? So you know what? I pulled a Cat Williams and I said, you shouldn't have been talking shit.
You shouldn't have been talking shit.
But yeah, I did pull a Cat Williams. I did say that, like, hey, dude, you most likely should have been talking shit. So after that, I, like,
I have not been on Twitter. I'm gonna get my ass off Twitter eventually, okay? I don't like that app. It's annoying. I'm gonna get back off of it eventually, but I've been spending less and less time on it.
And the main reason why I came back is because of all this streaming drama. Because I thought it was very funny. I was just like, ha ha ha. It was my wedding day. No, people was like, we don't talk about Bruno, but it was my wedding day. I was like, get it, girl. I just hopped on my Twitter. The thing about it is that, like, I have said numerous things numerous times about this man, Joe. Okay, so this was not anything new.
This is not the first time I have ever given my criticisms on Thomas in his show.
I do that all the time on this damn channel. That's why a lot of you guys are here. Yo, I'm so bad at putting on mascara, okay? I suck. I absolutely suck. Okay. Well, like, I have eyelashes now on this side. Yeah, let's go ahead and fix the other side now. So, I put on this, like I said, I pulled a Cat Williams. I had said this. I'm trying to see if I can remember it word verbatim. All I'm gonna say about this miraculous streaming drama. You shouldn't have been talking shit. I was like, you shouldn't have been talking shit on Kanto. And I was like, don't dog on this company when the mouse is the person that signs your paychecks, okay? And the mouse is usually Mickey. We refer to Mickey as that. We refer people that work with Disney or have partnerships with Disney as working for the mouse or working with the mouse. So basically, I told him to not bite the hand that feeds him, okay? One thing about me and a whole bunch of other people, we do not work for Disney. At least I don't work for Disney anymore, okay? So we are free to do whatever the fuck we want, okay? We can give our criticisms on their films and whatever. Like, even people that do work for the Disney films, they still are allowed to give their criticisms on the film and well, but you know, they kind of have to have their limitations on what they can say. This man knows damn well that Disney is paying him a lot to air this show. You'd think he would have been wiser and smarter about his decisions and what he had to say. This is not me over here defending Disney, but like I said, do not bite the hand that feeds you, okay? We know Disney is a super duper powerful company. They are borderline a monopoly at this point, okay? Disney has a lot of money, okay? A lot of people are able to make a living because of Disney. A lot of people's livelliholds depend on Disney. One thing that Thomas was one of these YouTubers that just talked a whole bunch of shit all day long about Disney movies and got like 5,000 views with little minimal effort. If it'd been one thing if he was that kind of creator. He is absolutely fucking not. He has a whole TV show. He has worked on numerous other animated shows that I have seen. And I'm not gonna lie, his writing could be good sometimes. It's just not good in this series. Like, y'all know he wrote Witch, right? Witch is like one of my favorite shows of all time. I'm gonna give it to him. I'll give him his credit when it's due. He did amazing when he worked on Witch. But this is not good. It's bad because it's like he has went back in quality. It's like he saw how this show blew up out of nowhere and it just gave him this inferiority complex where he feels as if nobody can touch him and that nobody can do shit for him because he has one of the most popular cartoons in the world. No, dude. Witch, your other shit, your other writing shit is much better, okay? Witch is a far amazing show. It's extremely beautiful. I do highly recommend you guys give it a watch. It's much better than Miraculous Ladybug. Damn, I shouldn't have been talking because my mascara done clumped up on me and I'm not done with it.
Now, this is in no way, shape, or form about me defending Disney
or capitalism for the most part, but I'm just like being smart and I'm just being real. There are certain shows out here that you guys ask me to watch and review, and the answer is no. And I'm not gonna say exactly what program they have came for. But a lot of people, I can tell you, people know what company I work for. It's like no secret whatsoever. I know how to keep my mouth shut when it comes to certain things like that. Because you want to know why? I got bills to pay, okay? I gotta eat, okay? I have to support myself. I'm being smart and I'm making the adult decision to keep my fucking mouth shut. If he didn't like Encanto, knowing that Disney pays him so much money for his television show, he could have just kept his mouth shut. He didn't even really have to say anything about him not liking the film at all. I think Thomas tends to forget that because he is this man of power. Basically, like, celebrities are like politicians. They're very famous, but a lot of them can't really do much of anything, especially when it comes to people in the film industry. A lot of people seem to forget that they can't do certain things that little regular schmegler-degler people or even just content creators do. There are times where you just need to shut the fuck up, okay? And a lot of people, like somebody said something about how a lot of people really can't say certain things because they'll be at risk of losing their job. That is why I don't talk shit about certain things that y'all ask me to. It's just making a mature decision to know when to shut the fuck up sometimes. Yes, freedom of speech is a thing. Yes, you can say what the fuck you want. But should you say what the fuck you want? Because even though freedom of speech is a thing, if you say something disrespectful to your boss, they have every right to fire you. They have every right to put you on probation, okay? As much as I don't like that sometimes, because a lot of these people do need to be put in their place. Freedom is like, people, you have the right to freedom of speech, but that doesn't mean that what you're saying is okay. And also, a side note about freedom of speech, a lot of y'all think that shit is the same thing as hate speech, and it is absolutely fucking not, okay? Moral of the story, just because you can say something doesn't mean you should, okay? And me basically telling this man that, well, I tell y'all, white fragility, not masculinity is fragile, but whiteness is fragile, okay? It is very fragile. This man really just blocked me because I just told him he should have washed his damn mouth. I find that so fucking funny. But that is the end of the story. I am good and ready to go to work. I just gotta put my jacket on and everything, and then I can be out the dough. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this funny little story time that I did for you all. It was fun making it. I just wanted something funny to talk about, something lighthearted, because these videos that I have been making lately, like my analysis, have been super duper sad, and I'm just emotionally now ready to pick them shits back up. I am going to be on set all day, so I'm gonna be super duper tired when I get home. I'm probably gonna snuggle up and get in the bed. I think I want to go get pizza from Whole Foods before I come home. I don't know what I'm gonna do. But I love you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and liked it, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below on how you feel about this entire situation with the creator Miraculous Label blocking little old me. You guys would like to follow me on everything. Everything is at Harianna. I also have a Patreon if you guys want to support me and all my work and on my channel and all that good stuff. I also have donation links down below. I also have a web series called The Progenies. It's basically just in this fan series. You guys can watch that. I don't know when a new episode's coming out, y'all. I'm so sorry. They'll be out eventually. Also, I have merchandise at HarianaHook.com. Okay. Love you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching and have a good night. 'Cause I were good to get to this point in my life. I'm blowing up, so don't hate, just congratulate. The Powerpuff Girls will just blow your mind. Buttercup by villains, three at a time. Bubbles will smile while kicking your butt, and Blossom will lead them out of their rut. Cherishing Powerpuff, two of a kind. Both wanna save the world before bedtime. From Townsville, Memphis, New York to LA, the Powerpuff Girls are just here to stay. They coming through and fighting, and everyone they shocking. You know no one can stop them all because of the Chemical X. They coming through and fighting, and everyone they shocking.